Well, here's T-Rox and I going somewhere locally to investigate something local. What are we going to investigate, T-Rox?
We're going to have a look at a quarry. A very old quarry.
I'm nearly sure of it.
1888 quarry.
Wow. Yeah, it's not far from me.
It's called Sugars Quarry, but I don't think it'll put our blood sugar up. Should be okay.
Well, it might.
We won't eat the rock.
I was going to go old school and bring my DSLR, but then T-Rex pointed out the stupidity of that. And I went, yeah, this is much lighter on my arm. Oh, look, scrub turkeys.
Look at that.
Wow. Just did a video on that.
Not one active brain cell between the lot of them.
Not one. Let's see where we end up. Forgot to mention, by the way, the fact that we crammed ourselves into the little T-Rex mobile here. I don't know how.
It's bursting at the seams.
Speaking of suspension, I'm replacing in my car. I think this one's going to be stuffed by the time we get pretty. So here we go, but whatever you do, don't touch the electric fence. Hey, T-Rox, what's this?
I don't know.
Is this one of those mines?
I think you might have discovered one of the lost coal mines of Moggill.
Really?
Yes, it's been quite a mystery for years. It's where those mines went.
How'd they fit in there?
These men would have to have been about 250 millimetres tall.
Yeah.
They were, not impossible.
They were short back then. Wow.
They needed to eat more hamburgers, that was their problem.
I reckon. We've just walked 600,000 metres. T-Rox is about to do his intro.
That was too much, I can't remember it.
He's forgotten his intro.
And I meant to print it a lot bigger than I did.
Oh. Well, you should just be psychopathic like me and know it automatically.
All right, let's see how we go.
Let's go now.
I'll stop looking at the sky before the camera. I'm down here. Come on, over here.
There he is.
Thank you.
Hey everybody, hey GeoNerds. Today we're at Anstead. Which, when I say we, it's myself and the awesome Steve Mack over here.
G'day.
And
he mentioned me.
We're at a place, well, this place used to be called Moggill, but you know, they split it off and made it Anstead. So we're here to look at a quarry.
Tune into T-Rox's video to see what he's talking about.
It's got a fairly unique rock in it, which we'll have a look at. And it's a very important part of Brisbane's history because hundreds of thousands of tonnes of aggregate from this quarry were taken down to Brisbane by barge back in the 1800s. So what makes this rock so special? Well, holy silica, Batman, that's what does it. So what we're going to do is have a close look at this quarry, the rock, the history, the people, have a bit of fun on the way. So if you dig the vibe, like and subscribe. And you know what we're going to say?
Let's rock!
What's this we found, T-Rox?
Rock. Absolutely. My professional opinion is that is definitely rock. What's in this case, rock? It's basaltic andesite. Oh, here comes people.
When we left the car, there was no one there. That's how friggin' slow
we're going. Just can't have a good idea by yourself anymore, you know that? And basaltic andesite.
Not even wearing my safety films today.
Wish you got
today.
Pants on today. It's a big improvement.
Yeah. I thought I'd better because it warmed up a bit.
That'll test your editing skills.
I'm not editing.
I'm not editing that out.
I don't remember seeing this. This is not where I went 25 years ago. There should be a river there.
Well, Steve, you can do stuff over and over again. You think it's all new. It's wonderful.
So here we are with T-Rox. We're going out in the T-Rox and Ville. Anyway, check out Tony's video. He'll have the real geology thing.
Maybe.
Mine's just full of crap. It's a bit of fun, isn't it?
They went to all the trouble of making this, Steve. The least we could do is walk.
Well, I'll edit it and magically we'll appear up the top because I've done walking 600 miles so far. Here we go. And here we are. That was easy. What's here? Sugars Quarry. Wow. Look at that. Huh. Well, this wasn't what I remember seeing 25 years ago.
Hey.
Yeah?
Is that running bear over there? A little white duck.
I'll see. Have you got your drone?
Yeah, dude, it's not going over water.
Mine's been over here.
This is what we're here to see, Steve.
Let's insert a cutaway shot. Oh, that thing.
That's the...
Oh. Well, I'm not walking down that. No way. Take two because I had it on photo. Here we are in Sugars Quarry. Tells you all about it. It's quite interesting. And here's T-Rocks to tell you a little bit more about what went on here.
Hey people, well there's a big hole over here. They dug hundreds of thousands of tons of basalt out of it. And they crushed it into aggregate, which they put on barges and took down to Brisbane to use as aggregate in concrete and in roadbase.
Wow.
And they did that from about 1888 through to about 1935, and then they had another go in the 60s, and they just kept going broke, strangely enough.
Let's have a look over here.
Kind of look over the edge.
Look at them. Whoa. They took a fair chunk of it out. Fair bit of it gone now, mate.
There's lots more. It goes about that way, about a kilometre.
Did we walk past it? Well, it's turned into grass, I see. How bizarre.
Yeah, this all caved in. See, that's a big slip, Steve. Gone straight down into the quarry.
Oh, that's really? Okay.
Yeah. When I get down the bottom, I'll take some photography for you, and it's you'll see the big slip coming through.
Yeah, so I might not go down the bottom.
You stand up here and keep an eye on things.
I will. I knew I should have brought my phone to call in the choppers.
I'll get in the bottom, I'll see you in a bit.
Okay.
Video?
Yes.
Just checking. Steve, just over the fence here, there is a massive ant's nest. Now, ant's nests are important in this area for two reasons.
Why is that?
One, ants bring up rocks from underneath and you can have a look in ant's nests and see what's under the ground.
Ah.
And of course, that's how this suburb got its name. Anstead. Facts. You might want to check that.
Somebody had his Weet-Bix for breakfast. Take him anywhere but out.
There's a termite mound there too. Little termite mound. I spied the termite mound. Lieutenant Dan!
It was a quartzy sort of rock. It's a rock amongst rocks. Rock around the clock. Hey, T-Rocks, look what I just picked up.
Oh, wow.
What is it?
It's
a rock.
A rock. Piece of, I'd say chert. Looks like a piece of chert.
Chert?
Chert.
Chert. Well, let's put it back to its natural habitat.
Hang on, it's about 4 inches over that way.
Shit, I'll go back.
Don't push now. Tell me, don't push me.
Because I'm close to the edge.
There's a drinking fountain.
There is.
It's going to be. What have we got here?
What we've got here is some chert.
Yep.
We have some quartz, we have some, probably some quartz, and some basalt, and some wallaby shit, and some more basalt, and some more wallaby shit.
Excellent.
Picture of Australia, really, isn't it?
Yes. Well, we've walked a little bit further.
Look at the way this is breaking up. See that? There's a nice little pebble.
Yeah.
That's natural, that's not, that's just the weather tearing the basalt apart. Rotting,
but there's a bit of a challenge.
I'm not doing that.
It's funny you can't get perspective on some videos, but
no, that's a lot of people are not.
You're gonna have to trust us.
People are going down there on horse, they're insane.
Now,
or you want to bet their mountain bikes?
Well, once upon a time, in the dark annals of time, I would have easily gone down there.
Yeah, but the problem is, Steve, we have to come back.
Yep.
That ain't
that's a long way down there. So, yeah. I know you can't get the perspective, but you have to trust us. when walking it.
So folks, here we have a really nice piece of the Sugars basalt. Now this is not actually a basalt, it's a basaltic rhyolite because it's very heavy in silica. But if you look closely in this, you'll see little tiny, they're like little lumps of colour in it. They're called amygdals, and the correct name for this is amygdalitic basaltic rhyolite. Yes, I know, I practiced that all day. So folks, I'm going to smack a bit of this off and take it home because you can see the little amygdals in this and I want to have a look at them closely, so let's just break a piece off. Most of that was for the camera. I don't need the first one, but anyway. Oh, would have been better if I'd pressed fucking record. Sorry, Steve.
It would have, and I'm leaving that in mine.
Let's do that again.
I had to grab the GoPro because it was slowly tilting forward.
I was getting knocked over, wasn't it? We're just going to smack a bit of this off for the to take back and look under the microscope.
Oh, it's a bit. You didn't need that much, did
you? Okay, let's hit it hard. I know. Got to hit it with the hammer.
Maxwell.
That's it.
Wow.
Oh, we got a good bit there.
I'm glad I've got it on action.
It's interesting how this is a different colour because it's not oxidised. But anyway, we've got plenty there. We'll take a few samples home and we'll look at them under the microscope.
For scientific purposes.
Fun and games. So there we go. And I'm going to take a bit of this home. We'll put it under the microscope because this is a very fine grained basalt. It froze very quickly. So we'll need the microscope. Luckily, we've got one.
There's the river.
This place is pretty interesting. We should make a video.
We should. We should do a video one day. How do we make a video?
I don't know. I have to read the instructions.
Oh, yes.
Oh, that's a nice piece there. I smacked off on this.
Lots of rocks. Anyway, in all seriousness, my video is just a bit of bug rising around, a bit so to speak. But check out T-Rox's channel because he'll take you through a proper geological tour, if that's the right word. I don't know. Cheers.